to you. He gon' give it to you. Crowder gon' give it to you. He gon' give it to you. Welcome back to my little channel. Yes, 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 a clickbaity title. I know. Did Steven Crowder advocate for fascism? And you know what? I'm not going to give you the answer right now. But trust you me, the question in itself, the question the title poses, isn't unjustified. So first off, what was fascism? Well, fascism was the movement in the early 20th century in Italy. We're talking about 1915 to 22 when Mussolini marched on Rome. So what happened in those years? Well, in those years, civilians got attacked by other civilians. But those other civilians tended to believe in the Bolshevik Revolution. And to prove to the other Italians that their revolution was good, they attacked them. They killed people. They destroyed companies by burning them down. They attacked farmers for farming. And the police, in a lot of these cases, did nothing. And politicians, at times, sided with the Bolshevik. Sounds familiar? Well, it should sound familiar because this is what we're seeing now in the United States. Okay, so far similarities. Are there more similarities? Well, yes, because eventually people rose up against the Bolshevik. They started fighting back. And those people, after fighting back on their own and being arrested by the police, because it's not that the police didn't do anything, they just didn't stop the Bolshevik. These people started to organize. This is also where the emblem of the fascists come from. The fascist is a bundle of sticks bound together, because lots of sticks bound together is stronger than each individual stick. And people started to organize and started resisting. I won't call it fighting back. In all fairness, it is fighting back, but let's call it resisting, because that sounds nicer. And this movement, after fighting back and pushing back the Bolshevik, the Marxist, the authoritarian groupthink, they started fascism. Fascism also based out of socialism. And so how did fascism start? Recap, it started by people organizing whilst fighting back against the terrorists that were the Bolshevik. So why would I then say that Steven Crowder is advocating for fascism? Well, watch this.
Yeah. People do need to stand up for themselves. I'm not saying go out looking for it. I'm not saying that commit assaults
as these people
who do you mean? I mean, black, white, red, yellow, and Antifa and Black Lives Matter, right? It's not a monolith. Yeah. It's a multicolored rainbow of assholes. What's at the end of the rainbow? Oh, a pot of another assholes. So don't say they. What do you mean, you people? The organization, the people who are involved, the people who try and curb stomp folks. And some people are going to try and fact check me. It wasn't a curb. It was in the middle. Okay, median stomp folks.
Jeez.
That's better.
They need to. It needs to stop working for them. Yeah, don't absolutely. Go out and act like them, but you need to protect yourself. And there are steps that you can take to do so that legally, hopefully, you're protected as much as possible. But we're at the point now where too many people have been brutally beaten. Right. And there is no help coming from their local representatives, certainly not from national representatives in the DNC, and we have not seen enough from President Donald Trump or Republicans.
So here's the hyperbole, because obviously Steven Crowder did not actively call out for fascism. Actually, he calls out for people standing up for themselves, which is, funny enough, how fascism got started. Do I think Steven Crowder is a fascist? No, of course not. Steven Crowder is, just as most people were in Italy at that time, sick of the violence coming from the left. Does standing up to the Bolshevik, the Marxist, the rioter always turn into fascism? Now that's the hard part, because it almost seems that it does. I can't really find any example of where it did not turn into some form of fascism. But not for the want of people to have it turn into fascism. It's more that this is the automatic response, it seems, towards groupthink. It's an us versus them mentality, and them are the ones attacking us, therefore us need to defend ourselves. Not individual self, but group self. I do hope, don't get me wrong, I do hope that in America we will see the first time that people stand up against active violence from the Bolshevik in the street without turning into fascism or any version thereof. But in all fairness, if I look at America, America has the best chance to do that, because individualism in America is praised and the group is built out of individuals. Now, funny enough, this is the same concept of fascism, but in fascism the state came for everything else. And I hope that in America the individual will still be the most important part. So in this, obviously, Crowder did not call for fascism, but he did call people to rise up against the violence. Try to do it in a peaceful manner, but if that's impossible, do not go silently into the night. Do I think Crowder is correct? Well, in all fairness, hell yeah. People need to stand up, and preferably now, before it becomes a shoot from the hip kind of response. Because once groupthink actually sets in, the us versus them mentality sets in, the chances of fascism grow bigger. Now, obviously there were countries where the Bolshevik Revolution did not turn people into fascism. Unfortunately, those countries turned into communism. So, out of the two, I still think fascism is preferable over communism, but I'd rather not choose one of the two evils. I'd rather stick with individualism. And in that, I agree with Crowder. People need to stand up and rise up. Stand and be counted. Because the politicians that allow this to happen, the police that allow this to happen, well, other than being your enemy, are also but individuals. Because once the Bolshevik Revolution continues, it will turn on the people that made the Bolshevik Revolution possible. Well, I agree it was a clickbaity title, but I do hope I explained a little bit how I came to it and what my answer to it is. Like, share, and subscribe if you feel so inclined. Criticism, as always, is more than welcome.